So welcome students, in this question you are given that Sn is equal to sigma r is equal to 0 to n 1 by ncr and Tn is sigma r by ncr. So what is the relation between Tn and Sn? So if you try to understand this question carefully, Sn is nothing but, so you go from r is equal to 0 to n 1 by ncr, that is 1 by nc naught plus 1 by nc1 plus 1 by nc2 plus 1 by nc3 plus so on plus 1 by ncn. And what is Tn? Tn is interesting. Tn is 0 by nc0, 0 by nc0 plus 1 by nc1 plus r is equal to 2, 2 by nc2 plus 3 by nc3 plus 4 by nc4 plus so on up to n by ncn. So, you are asked to find Tn by Sn. That is, in some way you have to try to express Tn in terms of Sn. Now, how do we do this? So, there is a very, very interesting way in which Tn can be expressed as Sn. So, what I do is Tn is equal to, so the Tn is nothing but the sum of this. I will write all these terms in the reverse order. That is, I will write n by ncn first. N by ncn plus what is the term before this? N minus 1 by ncn minus 1 plus n minus 2 by ncn minus 2 plus n minus 3 by ncn minus 3 plus so on to last you get n by 0 by nc0. Now what happens if you add these two? 2 times tn is equal to, so we use symmetry of binomial coefficients. We use the theory of symmetry of binomial coefficients. That is, nc0 will be same as ncn, nc1 will be same as ncn minus 1. The binomial coefficients from the starting and the end will be same. So ncn can be written as nc0, ncn minus 1 can be written as nc1, ncn minus 2 can be written as nc2, so on. So the denominators are same. So 0 plus n, that is n by nc0, plus 1 plus n minus 1 is again n by nc1, plus n by nc2, plus n by nc3, plus so on, plus n by ncn. That is nothing but, if you take n as common, 1 by nc0 plus 1 by nc1 plus 1 by nc2 plus 1 by nc3 so on is nothing but Sn. So 2tn is equal to n times Sn. So you are asked to find Tn by Sn is nothing but n by 2. Option A is the right answer. Thank you.